Now, reconstructivism is the fourth and the final part of the educational psychology series. So obviously, to reflect, to recall, we started off with perennialism. The emphasis was on the classics, social studies being, and philosophy and moral studies are considered far more superior. It was knowledge dependent. Essentialist was very similar. However, they gave they shifted from the classics to more contemporary subjects, and progressivism, on the other hand, was more grounded on constructivism. And finally, here we are on reconstructivism. Now, what is reconstructivism about? It was made popular in the U.S. by a scholar called Theodore Bremlin from Columbia Teachers College in the 60s. They wanted to talk about how, see, there's a big shift. In fact, it is a major shift from the other three. See, they wanted to talk, see, the first two philosophies talked about how content, or what content, which content is important. You know, remember, content was organized hierarchical, and certain forms of content are considered far superior than the others. The third one, progressivism, spoke from a perspective that, well, content was not hierarchical, but it was about how students participated in knowledge acquisition and things like that. But now, it's slightly different. It's different in the sense that they are arguing how students must be taught to bring about change. So it's not about understanding society, it's about bringing change to society. So students are no longer a recipient of knowledge from society through the education system, but the education system prepares students to go and participate in society and to bring about change. So reconstructivism is a philosophy that believes in rebuilding social and cultural infrastructure. Students are to study social problems and think of ways to improve society. Another proponent of reconstructivism is George Count. He was, especially in 1932, in a speech called "Dare the School to Build a New Social Order," suggested that schools become an agent of social change and social reform. Students cannot afford to be neutral, but must take a position in society. Most advocates for reconstructivism are sensitive to race, gender, ethnicity, and difference in social economic status. Related to reconstructivism is another belief called critical pedagogy. It is primarily a teaching and curriculum theory designed by Henry Giroux and Peter MacLean, which focuses upon the use of revolutionary literature in classrooms that is aimed at liberation. You will also see notions of this talked by Paulo Freire, where they believe that education needs to serve a bigger purpose. Education needs to liberate and emancipate the colonized mind. Education should be seen to be brought to be critical about the social environment, and to be critical of what is considered a social norm. Students are taught not to accept their condition as predestined, but rather to participate to bring about change.